Hello and welcome to Graphs Engineering. So in this video we will going to discuss about lifting beam finite element analysis using ANSYS workbench. So this present video is nothing but the continuation of our lifting beam analysis. So now in this video we will going to discuss the second scenario. So we can call this as part 2A also, and part 2B we will do that later on. So now let's move to the content of this. So this slide represent the learnings in this video. The learnings is as same as the part 1A. So like we will first discuss the problem statement, then we will actually perform the simulation in ANSYS where we apply the loading and boundary condition, and once our solution is performed then we will discuss the final results like stresses, deformation and reactions. Now let's move to next slide. So this slide represents the actual problem statement. So here we need to perform the FEA of lifting lug for a below loading and boundary condition. So basically if you see this schematic, this is nothing but the lifting lug and this is your lifting beam, which may consist of three lifting eye, and at the bottom you will find that there is 2 ton weight. So total 2 into 3, like 6 ton weight this lifting beam is carrying. So if you see here, in first part we discuss about that lifting is performed through the central lifting eye, and we splitted the part 1 in 2 parts. In part 1A what we did, we directly connected from this part to directly to the lifting eye with the help of rigid beam elements. In part 2B we discuss about, instead of rigid beam we consider this lifting hook and then we perform the simulation, and in that case we discuss about the differences in stresses when we have rigid beam and when we have lifting hook. Now in this part we will going to discuss about, for the same loading and boundary condition, we will just replicate the central beam part using these two outer lifting eye. So you can say that we will eliminate this lifting scenario, and now we will going to lift with this two lifting eye which is at the outer edge of the lifting beam. Okay, so all the loading boundary condition is as same as part 1A. Now let's go to the actual simulation and there we will discuss the present video. So before that I will going to take you to, so now you can see that this is what our part 2B part 1B where we discuss the comparison. So if I will show you, so this is what the lifting hook which we simulated, and now you can see that this is what the actual lifting hook we replicated, and also you can see that we created the contacts, lifting eye contact with the lifting hook. And at the last we also compare the two scenarios, like part 1A here you will find that rigid beam elements, and here you will find the lifting eye. Okay, so our ultimate purpose is that here you should able to simulate any kind of lifting scenarios. So that's why we are going in that much depth. Okay, here we are not only showing the FEA but we are also discussing the results. So now if you see here, these are like we lifted this lifting eye with the help of rigid, and here we perform lifting with the help of lifting hook. So you can see the differences. Let's visit our first video and there you can see the differences. Now let's move to the next topic of our present video, that is lifting with the outer eye. So for that I will just go to this is already seen. Okay, now this is what our the present lifting beam, and you will find that this is the lifting eye. Sometimes we can even call lifting lug or lifting eye. It's based on the manufacturer definitions. Okay, so basically this lifting beam consists of nothing but you can say that this is eye section beam, which may consist of lifting eye at the top as well as at the bottom, and it is supported with the help of stiffeners. Okay, so as we know that the very first we will see that the geometry which may consist of lifting eye, stiffeners as well as lifting beam, eye section beam. So we are using the same geometry on the same MIFI model where we first applied. Here you can see that we created this by selecting half of the portion. So you can see here, like, we selected the face and then we define the vertical distance here. Okay, and we applied a point mass of 2 ton. So you can see here 2 ton of point mass, similarly for second, similarly for third. So total mass of our structure, when we see here, it is 6.2491 ton. Okay, so same mass you should get at the reactions. Now the next part is material. So as we know that we are using by default structural seal, which is already available in our library. So same material we will going to use. So you can see that there are few mechanical properties like Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, which you will need to define the material. Okay, now the next part is like to create the lifting points. Okay, so for that you just need to right click over here, insert, and from geometry insert you will able to create this lifting point. So remote point, sorry. Now our next task is to create the remote point. Right click, insert, remote point. So what we are doing now, we will create a central hook lifting point. So I already created the coordinate system, you can see here, which you can create by defining the your XYZ, and in our case it is 1 meter from the center point to this. So I created accordingly. Now let's go here, select your face which you want to select for the lifting. So let's go to display and let me show you the faces. So here I already splitted this part. So if I am not wrong, let's show you in the X coordinate. So when the lifting is done, you know that this is nothing but the inclined lift, or here your hook or the chain will be inclined at some angle with this horizontal beam. So in that case you will have only small portion of surface which will going to come in contact. So there is no need to select the whole surfaces, you just need to split according to the diameter or the angle. So at present I splitted this much part. Okay, so you just have a select this, apply, and in the coordinate system you just need to select the local coordinate which you created over here. Okay, now next point you just define here 0 0 0, so that this lifting point will shift to here. When you put 0, you will find that our remote point is shifted here. Okay, now in similar fashion we will create another lifting point. So let's see here, this remote point you will have some behaviors, like here deformed member, rigid coupled beam. So beam behavior is basically it will rip when you click on the beam. Here you can even define the beam radius, so actually you can model the chain. Okay, and in case of coupled, it is basically used in case of coupled scenarios, which is not useful most of the time. And there are two incredible scenarios like rigid and deformable. So we will discuss the differences between these two later on, once we will complete this video. Then let's focus on the by default, that is deformable. Now the next, in similar fashion we will create the another point. So I will going to select the three faces, I will put local coordinate, and now I will shift this lifting point to the center. So let's put 0, 0, 0. Okay. Now we have created two remote points. Now in terms of contacts definitions, so there are two possibilities like you can do. You can first create the split this. Right now I selected all in a single part, so all components have sharing faces at the contact or at the connections. So in such a scenario, there is no need to define the contact connections, okay? But if suppose if you have different components in different parts, so in that case you need to create the contact between these faces, okay, at the meeting faces. Now the next task is that to perform the meshing, I am just using the previous mesh. So here I just did a few of the mesh definitions. So like for whole body, I defined the body sizing. Then for these faces, I had given the additional face sizing. So you just need to right click, insert, and accordingly you can define the different mesh control. So for that you can visit our videos for the meshing. Even that you can even define this map section meshing. So where it is possible, it will create the map meshes. And the next point, we are our area of interest is right now these two lifting eye, so that's why I am given the additional local sizing. Okay, now you can see that I am just going with the coarse mesh, but keep in mind you just need to make more fine mesh, at least 2 to 3 elements across the thickness in order to perform the correct FEA. Okay, so ultimately, as we know that our node count will increase, our simulation time is increased. So I am purposefully taking some coarse mesh, only some moderate or fine mesh at the area of interest. Okay, so that we will able to solve this simulation as early as possible. Now the next task is to apply the loading and boundary conditions. So as we know that our first ABC are nothing but the point mass which will act as a dead weight. So in order to consider the dead weight, you need to first apply the standard earth gravity or accelerations. So let's right click. Here you can define standard earth gravity. Now we can see that your standard earth gravity direction is in minus z, so you need to define like minus y. So I will discuss one more point here. You can apply a two ways, like here control c, and you can apply accelerations also if you want. And here you can define component, and here define you can y. So now here you can see that though standard earth gravity we are applying in negative y directions, okay, now when you are applying acceleration, so in that case in order to get the effect downward, you need to apply this upward. So that is the difference between acceleration and applying standard earth gravity. Okay, so the better way, you just go with the standard earth gravity. So I will just delete this. Now standard earth, so we applied the dead load. Now the next task is to apply the boundary conditions, so basically the fixing locations. So we will going to assume that our top lifting hook point, this one, is fixed in all degrees of freedom. So in that case I will just go into right click, insert, and then I will select remote displacement, and here just select the remote point. Here you select your first remote point, and then you can define the degrees of freedom. So what I will do, I will just lock all degrees of freedom blocked one. So this is the more conservative way, 0. Okay, now we created remote displacement as a 0 at first remote point. So similarly duplicate, and here just select the another remote point. Okay, so this is what our boundary condition, this is what our loading condition. Now next task is to perform the simulations. Okay, so just right click, simple, and you can solve this simulation. So it will take more time, so I already solved this simulation, so I will just pause this, stop, and I will take you to that deck. So let's go to that deck. So let's go inside this remote points. Okay, now this is what the simulation which we discuss. Now let's discuss the result part. So once you will simulation is performed, then you will find that simulation results. So these are already created simulation results. So what I will do, I will delete that and I will create in front of you. So right click, insert deformation. You can define total deformation. Right click, insert deformation. You can define directional deformation. Okay, and right click, insert. You can see the equivalent stresses. Evaluate all results. Now let's first discuss about the deformation. So now you can see that these rigid links are nothing but our, you can see that we have created remote point and we selected this face to this face. Similarly, we created point mass. So this point mass will going to connect with the face with the help of rigid links. So similarly, remote displacement also. So that's, you can see from here geometry and you can see that rigid link. If you don't want to see on results here, you just keep no. Now it will not show on a results. Okay. Now let's see the deformation. The maximum deformation, we found that this is at the central part, and if we want to animate that with a foe, let's animate this. Let's define the undeformed shape. Now you can see that's undeformed shape and deformed shape. Now let's animate. So now we can see that how it is deforming in actual scenario. So you just need to look into that here, like, are you really simulating that scenario or not? So now you've fixed these faces through that remote displacement and you can see that it is moving. Similarly, you can see here also. Now the next part, let's see the directional deformation. So I will see the directional vertical axis is okay. So it is in x axis. So basically x axis is this one. So let's animate this. It is negligible in case of x axis because we even restricted the rotation also. Okay, now let's duplicate this and now see in y axis, duplicate this and see the z axis and evaluate the results. So now you can see in y-axis. So basically the maximum deformation in y-axis only. So let's see from here. Okay, and similarly for z-axis. So you will not find any, or you can say the negligible deformation in z and x-axis and only the significance deformation in y-axis. Now the next thing is that to see the probe force reactions, and here you can duplicate without results and here you can define another one, evaluate. So you can check the reactions, the maximum reactions. So here the total force of 32,270 and here also 32,270. Okay, so you just need to calculate, add both the forces and then multiply by 9.81, you will get the same weight, or you can say the same mass which you applied. Okay, now I will show you just quickly, we will check that in a, so now we can see that 13,777. Now here you should get, see, 13,777 divided by 2, similarly here. Okay, so if you add both 7254, you will get 13,777, right, which you will find from here. Okay, so like that you can cross check your reactions, do the Excel work for that and put it in your FE report. Now that is all about your reaction validation. Now let's discuss the important part of our video, that is stresses. So I will just do some no wireframe, and I will put a true scale. Okay, now let's define the maximum value, which is coming at these edges. Now if you let's adjust some of the, now we can see that the maximum stress is found at the, I will keep this in on the S, and let's put on this stresses. Now we can see that the maximum stress is found on these rigid links, after the rigid links, so that might be localized in nature. So you just need to ignore that and report the stress after the one or two element away. Okay, now let's, I will hide that. Let's go to stresses, let's go to probe, and here you can see that the stresses. Okay, now these are the stress values which you can find, even here also some high stresses, even at this point also you will have some stresses. Okay, now even here also you can check some stresses. So likewise you can stress the check, and you just need to compare the stresses with the yield limit, and you can define the factor of safety. Suppose your yield limit is 250 megapascal. Now we are getting quite below with our yield limit, so we can easily say that our structure is acceptable as per the yield criteria. So that is all about our stresses when we have a remote displacement scenario from two outer lifting hook. So let's put over here, and you can see that like this. Now if you remember, I told you one point that there is different alternatives to create this. Either you can create by rigid points. So if I will go here, either you can create by deformable, either you can create by rigid, either you can create by beam. So beam will create the actual link, and there you can even define the material details. Now what is the difference between rigid and deformable? Okay, so the difference between rigid and deformable is that when we say the rigid, in that case this face will not going to deform. When we say that deformable, in that case this face will also going to be deformed. Now let's compare that with the actual simulation. I already simulated that just for the sake of to show the differences. So here if you see, this is like rigid, you can see here. So now what we can do, we can keep that in side by side so that you can see the differences. Now let's see the stress values, and now if you look into here more deeply, you can see that the differences. So I will put keep yes on the results. So now you can see the differences. You can see, like when we say the rigid, in that case it will create rigidly with this face and it will not allow this face to deform. Now here we kept it deformable, that's why it is allowing this face also deform, and you can say that some stresses relaxations. So this is the most conservative way. Now if you probe here, you will find that stresses are quite higher compared to this. So in this cases you can see, right, because we are rigidly connected to this face. So I will suggest to go with deformable because it will gives you more accurate result, though it is less conservative. But here in this case lifting, I will show the deformable faces also. Okay, and further one more thing, instead of selecting this much part, you just select the localized part like we selected in part 1A. Okay, so and then you can check the stresses, and also further you can increase some more values of the deformation dead loads. Okay, so that is the difference between rigid and deformable. You can do the practice at your end and you can actually see the differences. So that's it guys. So this is in all this part 1A, part 1B, part 2A1, part 2A2, and the next part will be part 2B. So in that case we will, instead of connecting to the rigid link, you can actually model the hook and then you can see the differences. So I will give this as a homework, you can do at your end and you can see the differences. So our ultimate purpose is not to just demonstrate the answers, but to discuss the result also, so that you will have the complete knowledge of how you can perform the simulations with the help of ANSYS tool. Okay, so please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channels. That's it guys. So this is, I will take sign off and let's meet in the another video. So thank you, bye bye, take care.